They call themselves the Guardians of the Galaxy.
What a bunch of a-holes.
Welcome to the OSWtv Podcast with Billy. Hopefully it sounds okay. I've got some different equipment this week. Basically, I'm not recording on my phone. I'm recording through a microphone, through a recorder, and I've got a headset on and everything. So I'm trying not to break it. I think that's it, because it isn't my recording equipment. So, listen to Billy on the OSWtv Podcast. I am on my own this month, this week, this edition, this episode. Because currently, my comrade, my cohort, is currently on the toilet. Not in my flat. I will clarify that. He is at his own home. Currently with projectile at both ends, I think was the term that I could probably use. Probably the cleanest I could use on the matter. But yeah, it's not a very nice situation. I don't really want that exposed to myself. So it's just me. And the reason I'm still doing this and just postponing it for a later date is because I want to speak about an event that's happening on Saturday. So we're recording on Friday the 10th of October, and the event I want to speak about is Saturday the 11th. I will pre-warn you now, I've had throat problems for the last 3 weeks or so, so my throat does sound a bit stuffy. I don't sound great, but hopefully you can ignore all that and just listen to my sultry voice and... we can speak about a little bit of wrestling. So we've got Discover Wrestling coming up on the 11th of September. No, why have I got September in my head? I've recorded this like 4 times now, and every time I've said September instead of October. 11th of September, I suppose that's quite a landmark date in everyone's mind, but this is 11th of October. I guess because I can't believe how quick this year has gone. It's October already. Unbelievable. It only feels like yesterday that I went down to Dundee and watched Dean Ambrose win the SWE Heavyweight Championship from Damien O'Connor, and now we're sitting in October and Ambrose is still a champion, so it's still messing with my head a little bit. But Discovery Wrestling, it was announced just after WrestleMania, so it was about April, May time, that they were having an event in Edinburgh, at the Meadowbank Sports Centre in Edinburgh. And the first big major guests announced were Al Snow and Mike Mondo. Mike Mondo, of course, Mikey from the Spirit Squad, Al Snow being Al Snow. And Al Snow versus Grado was announced for the event. However, due to TNA having Bound for Glory in Japan, I know, it's happening on Sunday. Do you not believe me? I know, you would think they actually built up to the event. We've got Al Snow unable to appear at the event. So Grado was moved to a different match with their new announcements. They announced Chris Sabin for the event, and they also announced Crime Time just a matter of days after JTG was released from the company after like 8 years he's been with WWE. He hasn't competed in like 5 of those years, but still, he was with WWE for 8 years, and they're bringing Crime Time over. So it was announced that Crime Time would team up with Grado, and they would face a challenge team, which was accepted by Joe Henry. Joe Henry! As you saw him last night on the SDV Appeal, Robo-Rero! That's my terrible impression of Scooby-Doo there, because he was dressed in a Scooby-Doo outfit. It looked very fetching for the global hero. But yeah, Joe Henry, Robo-Rero. It just sounds horrible, doesn't it? Robo-Rero. No, terrible. But yes, it was accepted by that. But then Grado had to be pulled from the event also, because BBC are doing filming for ICW Insane Fight Club 2. And Grado is required down in Liverpool. I can't do Scouts either. I'm not really good at impressions, so I can barely do Scottish, which is my own natural accent. So, yeah. Anyway. coughing as well. Coughing. Anyway. Right, we're going to speak about Discovery Wrestling. We're going to do it seriously now. With a serious tone. Yeah, Grado was pulled from the event, and it meant that it was going to be now just a tag team match, Crime Time versus Joe Hendry and a partner of his choosing. I have an idea who it may be, and I'm going to let you know what it is now. Out of all the roster members they have left that haven't got matches, I think it's only three guys who haven't got matches that have been announced. Noam Dar, Party Marty Skrull, and Deviation. This guy, Deviation, I think it's Deviation. I'm sure it's Deviation. He's a big dude with a mask. Nobody knows anything about him. I've never seen him before in my life. I don't even know where he's from. And I really want to see Noam Dar versus Party Marty Skrull. So, with that in mind, I think Joe Henry's mystery partner will be this unknown entity known as Deviation. Which makes sense in my head. And if I'm right, and it is Skrull versus Dar, as a wee bonus for you guys, it's going to be an absolute amazing time for you guys. I'm just, wow. Dar versus Skrull on top of everything else. But yeah, that's what I'm thinking at the moment. Joe Henry, come back to Edinburgh. Won't be looking to lose. So we'll be getting insurance, and that being the unknown entity known as Deviation, who's going to come and destroy folk for yucks. So I think that's a pretty safe bet. And if you disagree with me, then you can contact me, or we'll find out tomorrow night anyway who Joe Henry's mystery partner will be. Who knows? It could even have Alan, the co-promoter of the event, breaking out the Mr. News uniform. Who knows? It could be anything. Anything can happen when it comes to Discovery Wrestling. This is their debut show, so it could be a case of anything and everything could happen, or maybe not. I don't know. That's the thing with it being a debut. We've got no expectations. So you're going in with an absolute clean slate and watching a debut show from Discovery Wrestling. So the other matches have been announced, and I'll go through them one at a time. And the commentary team, one half of the commentary team will be Randy Valentine, which I can't wait for, and I'm still amazed that he is not a lisp, campy American, and that he in fact is Scottish. I'm still not quite over that situation, as I've been used to seeing him on video for years, wrestling related videos, promo related videos. He's got clothes on, and he's got this like, his ravishing accent, and I can't do accents, as I've already proven already in the 7 minutes I've been on. 7 minutes? I've been on for 7 minutes. I can't do accents. So it's got Ravishing Randy Valentine. He's not ravishing, he's just Randy Valentine, and he'll be on commentary, and he'll be hosting the event also with a plethora of talent, of names as well. So we're going to kick off one of the biggest matches, because we're going to go through the card. It's the Fatal 4-Way Elimination Match. I think it's Elimination, which has the best of the upcoming Y Division. You've got hashtag scumbag Ian Ambrose versus Damian Daniels, who some may know as just Damian in WrestleZone, versus Lewis Garvin, and a guy who needs no introduction, Chris Sabin. But I'm going to give him one anyway. The TNA Triple Crown winner, the pioneer of the X Division, the pioneer of the Ultimate X Match, former Tag Team Champion, X Division Champion, Heavyweight Champion, Chris Sabin is coming to Edinburgh at the Meadowbank Sports Centre, and he'll be in this Fatal 4-Way match, Fatal 4-Way Elimination match. So this is going to be really interesting, because if it is elimination, Ian Ambrose will make use of his 14 finishers that he has, from the ankle lock to the knee to the face to schoolboy to just anything. 14 finishers, that's his mantra, and he's been practicing. If you saw the Discovery Wrestling build-up that was on YouTube with Ian Ambrose, Alan Smith, and Randy Valentine, Ian's been practicing a lot with kicking out, so that's probably a good idea for him to do that. So it's going to be great. Luis Garvin, of course, is probably the least experienced out of all the guys in this match, but that doesn't mean he can't win. I mean, the former N7 champion in Pride, he's got all the makings to be a star, and he's proving that right now, and to have him in this match will be great for his experience also, working with guys like Chris Sabin, working with Ambrose, working with Damian Daniels, and you could get the upset victory. We never know, and there's going to be an absolute cracking match. So moving on slightly to the females, women of Discovery Wrestling. Discovery Wrestling are much like ICW in the way as they don't have a training academy. They're bringing guys from outside sources, so that means guys and girls come with already a build up behind them. So Discovery are lucky in that fact. This is a debut show. A lot of the guys they have coming in already have this mystique and this aura around them, and it helps the build so much because it means they don't have to do as much. Of course, they are doing a lot to plug the show, but they don't have to do as much when the guys that are there already have such a fan base already. So you've got the women's match, which is Sami Zayn versus Viper versus Portugal's perfect athlete, Shanna. And what can I say? Sami Zayn is probably the dark horse in this, I would say. I say that because she's probably not as experienced as Viper or Shanna in, say, wrestling in Europe or around the UK. I mean, she's done Rad Pro and places like that, but she's probably a dark horse in this because Shanna might not know her as much. Viper definitely knows Sami quite well through their multiple battles in quite a lot of companies, but Sami's still evolving. She's still not at her peak. So my prediction, and I've done a prediction for their matches, but my prediction for this one is going to be Sami taking the win, because when you have, as a Viper and Shanna, absolutely amazing, probably some of the best wrestlers in the world, male or female, and Shanna is very much a showboater, but she can fly, she can do all that kind of stuff. Viper, very technical, strong. Powerhouse, got that speed as well. But something in the back of my head just goes, Sami's going to take this. So if you want to find out, you should really go along and you can tell me who wins, because I really want to know. That's probably one of my most anticipated matches. I mean, this is a huge card. When the women's match is one of my personal most anticipated matches, it just shows how good these women are in the ring. And when you've got Viper, Sami and Shanna, oh, amazing. And our tag team match coming up is the new team of the Wild Lions, which is Andy Wild and Johnny Lyons against the Traditionalists. This will be interesting. I haven't seen a lot of the Traditionalists. I've seen Rob Cage before, one of the Traditionalists. They're, as far as I can see, they are modest dancers. And I just want to see Johnny Lyons and Andy Wild just ram whatever. Is it sticks or belt? I don't know. I'm not a modest dancer. Morris Minor, Morris Dancer. I'm not a Morris Dancer, so, or even seen them that often to know what they do. They have sticks? I think they have sticks. Oh yeah, they do the weird fencing thingy at the start, don't they? I don't know. Anyway, yeah, I just want to see Andy Wiles and Johnny Lyons beat them, because I really like this team. This is the first time they're teaming up. Andy Wild and Johnny Lyons, and I think they've worked with each other in the past. They've known each other well, and I think the chemistry will be there. The Traditionalists just come across as a little bit jokey, not taking this match seriously at all. And once you get Big Andy and Johnny in the ring, they will tear you from limb to limb slowly and make it as painful as possible on the opponent. So I'm really looking forward to seeing Wild Lions as a team, because it's just going to be absolutely brilliant. I know you're listening to this podcast now and thinking, man, he says absolutely quite a lot, and baby, I say it a bit more as well, going up in the show. So that's the other tag team match. Will Scott, I said, Crime Time versus Joe Henry and a partner of his choosing, which I think is going to be Deviation. And the other matches announced are still huge as well. So last two matches I'll go through before we go into another subject. We've got Rampage Brown versus Damian O'Connor, two heavyweights. We saw the build up to this match on the Discovery Wrestling YouTube channel. It's personal already. Rampage being very nonchalant and thinking he's just going to pick up Damo into a pile driver and that's going to be it. Damo, of course, wanting to make an impact straight away in Edinburgh against Rampage Brown. I don't know a lot about Rampage Brown, I'll say that now. I've seen a couple of his matches online, but I haven't seen enough for me to go, oh my god, this will be it, this will be, he'll do this, he'll do that. I couldn't judge it that way. However, I will say, after watching the video and seeing Rampage being, for the lack of a better word, a dick in the video, I know his character, so it's alright, but it pulled me in, me thinking, oh my god, this guy is an art dick. I want Damo to stand in his chest, sent on him, kill him. Not literally, like figuratively, kill his soul. And walk out of Edinburgh in the Meadowbank Sports Centre with a cape made of Rampage Brown skin. So this is going to be absolutely electric. It's going to be heated. It's a big heavyweight clash between these two. And as I said, I want Damo to absolutely destroy Rampage. But we'll just have to see what happens. And the other match, the main event, what this event was named after, Discovery Wrestling's No Fear, No Mercy, it is Joe Coffey versus Mike Mondo. Mike Mondo, of course, Mikey from the Spirit Squad. Mikey! He'll be, not Mikey, but he'll be Mike Mondo coming over to Scotland, to Edinburgh. And he got to choose his opponent. Discovery let him choose his opponent. They said to Mike Mondo, you could choose anyone in Scotland, anyone in the UK to fight you. And he chose Joe Coffey. Joe Coffey, the Iron Man of professional wrestling, will be looking just to absolutely destroy him. SWA Heavyweight Champion, and he's Iron Man at ICW. What more can you say about this guy? Joe Coffey has got all the makings to be a humongous name in professional wrestling, if he isn't already. And Mike Mondo might have bitten off more than he can chew, but I'm sure Mike Mondo, he's worked with guys like Shawn Michaels, Triple H, Ric Flair. I'm sure the challenger Joe Coffey isn't phasing him, but it should be worrying him, because Joe Coffey is one of those, much like Sammy, is still not at his peak. He can still get better, he's still young, and he will still get better and better and better and better, and he'll always be learning. Much like any professional wrestler, they'll always be learning new things, but as a younger person, you might be more able bodied to try new things without too much fear of breaking anything or anything like that, because you're younger, your body's will heal quicker. So Joe Coffey versus Mike Mondo is going to be one of those matches where you don't know what's going to happen. Both guys are I wouldn't say similar, but you could definitely pair comparisons between the two, and it's going to be electric. So I don't know what else is going to happen at the event, but there's still limited tickets available. You cannot buy tickets online now. That closed off last night at 5 o'clock. So if you still want to get to the event and you haven't got a ticket, then you have kept it late. But you can go to the Meadowbank Sports Centre on Saturday, and hopefully there'll be some tickets available at the door, and you can get a ticket. If you can't get a ticket, then I'm hearing there might be some TV cameras there. So maybe we'll see you in the future as well. So stay tuned for all the news on the Discovery Wrestling Facebook page, and also on the OSWTV page, because I'll also keep you up to date as much as possible as well. Right, so that's out the way. As we've spoken about Discovery Wrestling, I say out the way like, oh, I need to get through that, but I want to speak about Discovery Wrestling. As I know it's been 20 minutes now, if you're still listening to it, you are an absolute gent. I'm going to speak about Rock and Wrestle next. We're going to look at Firestorm Pro Wrestling. Well, I'm not. Will Little from Firestorm Pro Wrestling. We'll be speaking about it. I'll have that later on in the show. And we'll have a look a little bit about maybe a bit about WrestleZone, a bit about SWB as well. We'll put that in there as well. Coming up on OSWTV. So Rock and Wrestle, not a lot has been announced for this, I'll be honest. They've got the Highland Slam Tour, which is the 17th and 18th, which is Strathpeffer on the 17th and Forest on the 18th of October. And that's not a lot has been announced. They've had BT Gunn versus Chris Travis announced, but Chris Travis is currently out sick, so I don't know if he will be at the event. If he is, fantastic, he'll be facing BT Gunn, but I haven't heard anything whether he is or isn't at the event, and that's worried a little bit because it's coming, it's a week until their first show, and not a lot has been put up about it. And yes, it worries a little bit. We've got Chris Redfrew has been announced for the event. Luke King Sharp has been announced for the event, and that's about it. On the poster, we've got Kenny Williams, Kid Fight, Liam Thompson, Carmel. I mean, we've got all these, and Jack Jester. We've got all these names on the card on the poster. Nothing's been announced, and hopefully there's absolute screed of match announcements over the next week. So stay tuned to the OSWTV Facebook page and I'll keep you up to date. Facebook.com/OSWTV and I'll keep you up to date along with the Rock and Wrestle announcements. I will be at the event, so if you are going along to either event at Strathpeffer Pavilion or the Victoria Hotel in Forest, give me a shout, give me a wave. I'll wave back, and if you want to talk, well, we can make some awkward conversation. So that's going to be great. So coming up next on OSWTV Podcast with Billy, as Kevin is ill, I'm going to play a little piece from Firestorm Pro Wrestling. Will's going to speak about Firestorm Pro Wrestling next, and I'll be back to speak a little bit more about professional wrestling in Scotland. So enjoy.
First of all, I'd like to thank Billy Strachan here for the time to do this interview. Let me introduce myself. For those who don't know, my name's Will Little. I'm one of the promoters for Firestorm Pro Wrestling. I'm here based in Fife alongside Tom Bater and Drew Marshall. Wow, Firestorm Pro Wrestling. Initially, what happened is we ran our first show back in 2012. But we weren't known as Firestorm Pro Wrestling. It was essentially like Tom and I just got together and ran a charity show for one of our friends who lost their dad to cancer. So it was back in 2012. We couldn't have done it, to be honest with you, without a few people. First of all, Mike Musso from W3L, who let us use the ring. It was such a good show, to be honest with you, from what I remember. A lot of the guys worked, because it was a charity show, you know, a lot of guys went out there and they still worked, like it was like a main event show. One guy in particular, who's become a mainstay with Firestorm Pro Wrestling, and we'll get to later on, is the unstoppable Andy Wiles. Top guy, absolute, by far one of the best in the UK to date. So that show was a success. We raised £500 all in all. 250 went to cancer research, and 250 went to St. Richard's Hospice, where our friend's father was at the time of his passing. So yeah, that was when Tom and I realised that we worked well together as a team, and you know, things worked well. So we thought, you know, this could be something that we could do. So, you know, like, fast forward a few years, toying with the idea of actually like starting our own promotion, which, you know, bit heat for it, but, you know, it was expected. So yeah, the first Kapow came about when I approached Tom again, because we worked so well, we've been friends over the years. I approached Tom about doing another charity show for the special care baby unit of Kirkcaldy Hospital. A bit personal story. My daughter, Sophie, was born in 2012, and we almost lost her. She was in the hospital for a good few weeks. I didn't know if we were getting her home or anything like that. So we decided, you know what, we did. We got her home, and she's now 3 in April, and by far the most important thing in my life. To raise £400 for the special care baby unit. We couldn't have done it without a select few guys. Again, believe it or not, Andy Wild. And especially a lot of the SWV guys. All Night Unit Bros, Martin Stallion. So that was like our first like run under the Firestorm banner. The show was a success. So that kind of got us going, where it's like, you know what, we could actually do this. You know, we could actually try and actually make, I don't want to say a living out of it, but you know, like make something of it. To fast forward a few months after that, which brought us to last Sunday, where Firestorm Pro Wrestling brought you Fight Night. Massive thank you to Ross Watson, Kid Fight, for the training seminar beforehand. PBW has such talent in their pool, from JD Bravo to a guy that I've always been a fan of, Switch. Such creativity. I generally think there's a lot of good things in store for Switch. Another one who I think has actually got a bright future ahead of him is Luke King Sharp. So talented for such a young age. The man is definitely going to go far. And well, I don't want to just say Scottish wrestling, because I mean, he's young enough. The world is his oyster. The world is his oyster. And if anybody could do it, I truly believe in Luke King Sharp. On that night, we crowned our first ever Firestorm Pro Wrestling champion. Surprisingly, or not surprisingly, Andy Wild. He's helped us out whenever we've asked him, training seminars. At the first Kapow, he worked with one of our trainees, Craig Valent. It's Craig's first match, and typical Andy Wild fashion, he brought out the best in Craig. The match looks, you can YouTube it. Firestorm Pro Wrestling on YouTube, look it up. The thing with Andy is he's one of the talented people that, you know, you could stick him in the ring with, you know what I mean, with absolutely anybody, and they can have a 5-star match. But the match on Sunday, at Fight Night, he was in there with a long time friend, the tenacious Johnny Lyons. I've known Stuart like my whole entire career, if you will. It was Stuart that took me to my first ever W3L training class, on a really damp Sunday morning at 9:30 in the morning. So essentially, I have Stuart to thank for everything. I wouldn't be sitting here recording this interview about essentially my own company if it wasn't for Stuart. The next show that we have, Chaos in Cross Hill. The tickets are on sale now. £10 adult, £5 children. One match that we can confirm, is long-time rivals in the SWE, is Ian Ambrose against Martin Stallion. These two guys just absolutely give it everything when they're in the ring. I've seen a couple of their matches now, and you know what? I don't get tired of seeing them. Two tremendous, tremendous workers. Just the talent between the two of them alone, you know, that it just speaks volumes. They work so well together. Do you know, I always find that it's sometimes rare to find two people who actually work well together all the time. You know, sometimes you can get bored of seeing the same matches, but then when it comes to Ambrose and Stallion, it's just quality stuff. Doors for that, 5:30, first bell at 6. Seems to be pretty standard. With Firestorm, have 5, 6, you know. But I think from like a personal standpoint, there is a few people in wrestling now that I personally myself need to thank. Mike Musso, for one, for giving me the chance to train and just learn from him. I've learned so much from Mike. Another one is, seems to be everybody's best friend recently, Big Dave Madison. Big Dave used to wrestle on the scene as Invincible, W3L tag team champions with the Governor, Carl Conroy. Dave has been instrumental in helping me a lot with confidence issues. I don't mind talking about it. You know, Dave took me under his wing and he sat and he you know, we just sat for hours just talking, and he's helped me to become who I am today. So yeah, big massive thank you to Dave. Plus, it was Dave Madison who actually let us use his hall and his ring for all the shows so far, except the first one in 2012. So I mean, a big massive thank you to Dave, and his whole entire family are just so good. Firestorm Pro Wrestling, the future, hopefully it's only going to get bigger as the time goes on. I mean, the Chaos and Cross Hill show is the last one of the year. Next year, there's a few surprises in store. You know, just keep your eyes peeled. facebook.com/firestormprowrestling. Any other information, email firestormprowrestling@gmail.com. Big massive thank you to Bella Strachan for the time. Thanks, bye.
And welcome back to OSWtv Podcast with Billy. Hopefully the sound hasn't sounded so bad. I'm trying to make this as professional as possible, but I'm very aware that I can hear my own microphone moving, so that's not really great. I am the big cheese of OSWtv, and thank you for Will for recording that for us on Firestorm Pro Wrestling, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you want to know more, of course you can go onto the Facebook page, which you just type in on your search bar, Firestorm Pro Wrestling, and I'm sure you'll find them no problem at all. So we've got a couple of events coming up in October, and the next one I'll speak about outside of the ICW Magical Mystery Tour, which will be covered by guys like WrestleShark and places like that. So I don't want to speak about too much. So I'll speak about SWE Uprising, which is the 25th of October. They've got Paul London, Brian Kendrick, and Liga Von Dutch at the event. I am putting up a preview. I've already put up a preview on the OSWTV WordPress account, which is oswtv.wordpress.com. It will be updated, though, in the week or so coming up to the event, because there's matches to be announced that I haven't actually put on the review, like Leo Von Dutch versus Nikki Storm, which will be amazing. Leo Von Dutch trained by WWE Hall of Famer Edge against the greatest wrestler in the galaxy, Nikki Storm. Wow, that's going to be insane. It's Damien O'Connor teaming with Claymore against MDK and Darren Blair. This is the fallout from Hell for Lycra, of course. And it's going to be a very hard hitting match. Three big dudes and then Darren Blair, will probably get his arse kicked by Damo through the ropes, because that's what Damo does. He kicks people in the arse, stands on their chest, because he is a bear. Rawr, a bear. So along with that, we've also got Joe Henry, Robo Rero. Sorry, I've already mentioned the Scooby-Doo thing. I may have already mentioned the Scooby-Doo thing on the STV appeal last night, appearing dressed as Scooby-Doo. So there was my piss-poor impersonation of Scooby. I have already mentioned it. Oh, sorry, guys. Sorry, guys. You've listened for about half an hour, and I'm now going through material I've already said. So, yeah, we've got Joe Henry versus Paul London, the Intrepid Traveller. So, Intrepid Traveller versus Global Hero. What a combination. Joe Henry, of course, being a big dude, big powerful dude, can throw in some technical wrestling when he needs to as well, against the high flyer Paul London. It's going to be a great meshing of styles. And we've also got Little Johnny Trouble, LJT, versus Brian Kendrick as well. Brian Kendrick, of course, being a former WWE champion, but it's not been recognised by the WWE. An absolute shocking indictment of the championship scramble system. But yeah, so LJT will be facing a former WWE champion October 25th. You know, you would think that I've got a calendar in front of me. I'm looking at it, and yet I'm still thinking it's either September or it's May or it's May. Sorry, I've now got just some tibbleick in my head. This has been quite random. My throat's getting worse. Oh, hello. You're listening to the OSWtv podcast. We're going to start again. Why not? With Billy, I'm the big cheese of OSWtv. Ah, man. This has just been disastrous, this last little bit, hasn't it? So we've got that big event coming up on the 25th at the Ardler Complex. Ardler Complex, of course, was due to no longer have SWE events, but SWE website has said, due to fan support and petitions, the wrestling is coming back to the Ardler Complex. So that's great news for Dundee. And hopefully we'll see SWE grow and become bigger and a bigger company because of it. The next event I'll be going to will be in November after the Highland Slam tour for Rock and Wrestle. I'm hoping to attend WrestleZone Live in Huntley. This will be the build-up to... it'll be the aftermath of Halloween Hijinks, which will have Aspen Faith, the King of Catch, versus Crusher Crave, the Undisputed Champion. And I, for one, can't wait for that. I'm not going to be at Halloween Hijinks, I wish I was, but we're going to see Aspen Faith, hopefully. Me personally, he might be the heel, might be the bad guy, the King of Catch himself, but I really want to see Aspen Faith as the WrestleZone heavyweight champion, undisputed champion of WrestleZone, and I want him to beat Crusher Crave. I think Crave's awesome. Crave is fantastic. I'd love to see him go around different companies, go around other companies. But I really, really want to see Aspen Faith as the WrestleZone heavyweight champion. I think he's worked his arse off for the last year or so. He hasn't lost a singles match since April. So it's going to be a very, very good match. And I just can't wait for it. I think it's going to be fantastic. So as soon as I know the results, I'll be putting them on the OSW Facebook page as well. And it's going to be great. It's going to be really good. So that's going to be the next event I'll be going to. So if you want to get any reviews in, if you want to write for oswtv.wordpress.com, I'd love to hear from you. Contact us, voiceofosw@gmail.com, and I'll get back to you as soon as possible. So not in a dickish way, like going, "Oh, we'll see how your writing is." No, I want to see, I want to read your passion for professional wrestling. That's it, really. My writing isn't great. I've had some great feedback on some of it, but in general, I work on passion. I wouldn't do any of my writing without passion. I don't see the point otherwise. So if you want to write for us at all, write for me on OSWTV, I would need to see that passion. I need to see the passion so badly that makes you basically love wrestling so much that it's bursting out of you and you have to tell someone about it. It's bursting out so much, it's made me cough there. But yeah, it's bursting out you so much that you have to write about it. And so if you want to get in touch with us, fantastic. So this has been quite a quick edition of the OSWTV podcast, mainly because I'm on my own. And I would have liked to have someone here to bounce off opinions and things like that. But for the time being, this is going to be it for this edition of the OSWTV podcast. This has been Billy, just myself this month, this edition, this episode I said, we're going back through old ground I've already went through in the previous 20 minutes at the start of the podcast. But yeah, hope you've been listening. Hope you've been enjoying yourself. If you haven't enjoyed yourself, then that's a shame. It really is. I'm very sorry about that. If you want to do anything, if you heard that piece by Will Little, if you want to contribute at all, get in touch with us at all, I would love to hear from you. You've been listening to Billy from OSWTV. If you haven't been listening, well, you know what I'm going to say. Go fuck yourself. Thank you, and good night.